हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम वेलकम वंस अगेन। होपफुली दैट यू ऑल आर गुड एंड एंजॉयिंग द लेक्चर्स। हैव यू ऑलरेडी सीन द प्रीवियस पार्ट ऑफ द सेकेंड चैप्टर? सो मैनी थिंग्स दैट आई ऑलरेडी टीच इन दैट चैप्टर दैट आर ऑल्सो मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट। ओके, बट हियर आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू some most important topics and some most important things related to this chapter, some points which you have always remember from the previous chapter. There are so many points about the pituitary gland, thyroid gland, pancreas and rest of the other gland, that is adrenal gland also. Here the topics that we are going to cover are very most and most important. First you see the topics. The topics that we are going to cover in this lecture, number first, that is feedback mechanism of hormone. Feedback mechanism of hormone. Okay. This one will always come, always, not in always, but in, I think that it will become in the alternate exam, then that is in 3 marks. If the question will come from this feedback mechanism, then it will be always come in 3 marks. Okay, this one, feedback mechanism. Second one that we are going to start, that is nervous system. Nervous system or the unit, that is neuron, neurons diagram. Here we will know about the neurons diagram, but so many points that we are going to cover today in this lecture. But first to see the feedback mechanism. Before the feedback mechanism, one topic is remaining, not that topic, one hormone is remaining, just only you have to learn about that hormone, because in 10th class that is no, that one is not in detail one. Okay, that is hypothalamus gland. Okay, it is just present above the pituitary gland. It means pituitary gland are present in the base of the brain, just above that hypothalamus gland is present. The shape is very clear, that shape is rounded or oval. Okay, the main thing is that this hypothalamus gland is called as super master of gland. It means, this one is important one, pituitary gland you told that master of gland, that is correct. Hypothalamus is the super master of gland. It means this gland control the secretion of pituitary. So this one is important. Now come to the feedback mechanism. Feedback mechanism. In feedback mechanism, just first you listen it very carefully. Feedback means, suppose you have to do any work, suppose that any work that you have to do, then you have from other side some feedback will become. Suppose that if you buy any product from Amazon, Flipkart or anything, or any sites, okay, suppose you buy some feedback, suppose you buy some product, okay, so after delivery, okay, the feedback option is there in the Flipkart. Okay, so you have to write that what about that product, is reaching correct time or whatever is that. Okay, suppose that you the simple way, suppose that you have to just install any application in from Play Store in your mobile, in Apple, that is Apple Store. Okay, so there is a feedback, it's been a star, and some points that you have written about that application. So same thing is there, that is feedback. Feedback means, suppose that one hormone is there, that is suppose that thyroid. thyroid gland. Suppose that this thyroid gland is there. Okay. So above that, pituitary gland is there. Because one example that I have taken in your course, any gland will become okay. Thyroid gland secrete thyroxine in a particular area. In a particular area that I told that target organ. Target site. So this thyroid gland release thyroxine to the target area, it means target organ. Okay, but the secretion will be controlled by the pituitary gland. Clear? Please avoid the noise if the noise will come. Okay, so pituitary gland. Clear? So pituitary gland is master of gland, but here hypothalamus is super master of gland. So above the pituitary gland there is a hypothalamus gland which control pituitary gland. So suppose if we left the pituitary gland and hypothalamus gland, the thyroid gland do not secrete that thyroxine hormone on the specific site because thyroid gland wants some information or some guidance from the pituitary gland. Okay, so at that time pituitary gland release TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone. TSH, that is thyroid stimulating hormone. Clear? Thyroid stimulating. Stimulating means stimulate it to thyroid gland. The pituitary gland release thyroid stimulating hormone which activate the thyroid gland to release thyroxine on the target site. This point is clear. So if we are going to write it, so here pituitary gland, thyroid gland, thyroxine and target site. This one is clear? Everybody clear or not? Now next one. So pituitary gland, that is TSH. So hypothalamus is controlled to the pituitary gland. So hypothalamus release TSHRH. Here we will write the full form TSHRH. Thyroid stimulating hormone, relaxing hormone. Thyroid stimulating hormone and relaxing hormone. In some book it was here that is releasing hormone, that is in NCERT that is relaxing hormone or releasing hormone. Here don't think of, okay sir, TSH, that is RH. Okay, so here that is read TSH, it means thyroid stimulating hormone. It means this hormone is release hormone, relaxing hormone. It means relax it. It means this thyroid hypothalamus gland release TSHRH to the pituitary gland, that this pituitary gland release TSH, that is thyroid stimulating hormone, okay, which stimulate thyroid gland to release the thyroxine on a target site. Okay, so the simple way, that is positive. So the green one, that is the green color, is that this one is called as positive response. Because normally it was done. Any circumstances were there. So normally it was done. That is okay. Now, if suppose that, if the level of thyroxine will be higher, because you know that in both condition, hypo and hypersecretion, there will be a disease. So if the level of thyroxine on a target organ is become higher, so at that condition thyroid gland, not other gland, thyroid gland directly connect to the hypothalamus, directly give response to the hypothalamus, okay, that you control the secretion of TSH, RH, okay. So hypothalamus control the secretion of TSH, RH. So if the secretion is less, so it will be not activated, and this hormone, that is TSH, will be not releases, okay. And later that thyroid gland will not any information, that it can be not secrete thyroxine on a target organ, okay. So this one is called as negative response. This one is positive. Positive means if the secretion is higher, so that is negative response, okay. Now one more thing, once again that I am going to tell you this thing, because this one is most important. First, you listen very carefully, okay. Suppose that here is a level, okay. Once again, that I am going to repeat it. Thyroid gland secrete thyroxine on a target site. It means a specific site, a target organ. Thyroid gland was controlled by the pituitary gland, and pituitary gland was controlled by the hypothalamus gland. Clear? Pituitary gland. Once again, thyroid gland will not stimulate thyroxine at that when pituitary will not give the information. So the time at which pituitary give the information in the form of hormone, that is TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone, so at that time thyroid will stimulate, okay, and release thyroxine hormone on the target site. But pituitary gland was controlled by the hypothalamus gland. So first, hypothalamus gland release TSH, RH, that is thyroid stimulating hormone and relaxing hormone, to the pituitary gland. Later, pituitary gland releases TSH to the thyroid gland. Thyroid gland releases thyroxine, and thyroxine release, it will be secreted on the target side. This one is the positive response. Suppose that if the secretion is higher, suppose that thyroxine, the level of thyroxine will be increases on the target site, okay, then thyroid gland give negative response to the hypothalamus gland, okay, is that you have less the secretion of TSH-RH, so the secretion is become less. Later pituitary gland will become less secretion of TSH, later thyroid gland will be secretion, the thyroxine releases will be less. So these are the feedback mechanism, okay, of the hormone. This question, okay, will be asked to you for any hormone. Suppose that here they will write adrenal gland. So you all know that adrenaline hormone, okay. So here ASH, that is adrenaline stimulating hormone, ASH-RH, that is adrenaline stimulating hormone and relaxing hormone. So many things are there, okay. Suppose here pancreas releases insulin to the target site. So there are so many question will become. One example that is based on the thyroid gland, you know, okay. Now come to the next one. That is nervous system, okay. Nervous, from it, okay, hormones part is completed. Now come to the nervous system. Nervous system are basically, or first we will see the nerve cell. First we will see the nerve cell or neuron. Nerve cell or neuron. The diagram that you already know in class 9th. Okay, maximum part will be labeled. Here the same diagram is there, because in your books, in class 9th or in class 10th book, okay, maximum 4 or 5 labeling will is there, but here I am going to tell you maximum labeling of the nerve cell. That is nerve cell, that is a branch. Okay, so first you see the diagram or some points. First you see the diagram, because point you know. Nerve cell diagram is just like a branch of tree. This is the nerve cell diagram. This is the nerve cell diagram. Okay. You have to already draw in class 9th. The same diagram is there, no any change. Okay, and labeling will be same that you study in class 9th. So this one is the diagram of neuron, that is nerve cell. Now come to the labeling. First thing that I'm going to tell you, if you are in class 10th, if you are going you are going in board examination, so what are the method that you will use to draw the diagram? Suppose that this one is your page and this one is your margin. Okay, suppose that this is your page. Okay, so you have to draw the diagram left side of the page. Here you draw the diagram here, and labeling should be like this. Labeling should be like this. It means in a proper manner. It means in equal, that is here. Okay, so this type of labeling should be there. Okay, don't cross. Suppose that your labeling is here, so don't cross it. This type will be not considered or not checked in any examination. So this type, this way you have to draw the diagram. Now first you see that. Okay, if the partition is there, you have to use this part also, no problem, but maximum thing you have to draw that. Okay, you see that neuron or nerve cell are divided into two part. The first, this part is branched part, and this one is unbranched part. So this branch part is called as cyton. Okay, and the unbranched part is called axon. Two point is clear, cyton and axon. The first point you have to write the point also. If I'm not going to write it here, you have to write the point also in your copy, proper description of that diagram also. Okay, now in cyton region, you have seen that there are so many branches are there. The branches are called dendrites. Okay, and the branches from where the branches are arise is called as dendron. Okay, clear. Now the liquid which are present in the cyton region is called as cytoplasm. It's called as what? Cytoplasm, the liquid. This is called as nucleus. Okay, and the dotted like structure which was green in color is called as what? Nissl's granules. Nissl's granules. Nissl's granules. Everybody clear or not? Now come to the next one. You see here, this is the place. This one you see. This is the place where cyton and axon are together. This portion is called as what? Hillock. Hillock. Okay? Clear? Now, from here to here, there is an axon. So, the liquid which are present inside that axon is called as exoplasm. Exoplasm. Okay? The layer of axon is called exolema. Exolema. Clear? The cover, you see the blue marker, that is, the cover is called as myelin sheath, and the cell which are help for making that myelin sheath is called as Schwann cell. Okay, Schwann cell. There's the apostrophe, yes, it means scientist. Your Nissl is also a scientist. So this one, you see that gap in between the two myelin sheath, there is a gap. This one is a gap. Here also it's a gap. So this gap is called node of Ranvier or Ranvier's node. Node of Ranvier or Ranvier's node. Point should be clear. Now come to the next one. You see at the tip, this one, this structure is called axon terminal. Terminal is tip. Clear? See that at the tip of axon terminal, some button-like structure or knob-like structure are present. This knob-like structure called synaptic knob. So these are some labeling. You see that no any crossing will be there, and the labeling will be in the linear way. Okay, so some points will be clear. Okay, so when we are going to cut, okay, when we are going to cut all this one, that is cross section of synaptic knob, because that is in your course, and maximum question will also come in that. Suppose that this portion will be cut it, and here we are going to what? Elaborate it. Here we are going to what? Elaborate it. Okay. Now listen very carefully. If you are going to elaborate it, okay, if we are going to elaborate it, so many things will be there. This one, you have to draw like this. You have to draw like this. So this is the basic diagram or oval diagram. There are so many things are present in that. So many things are present in that. First you see here very carefully. Okay. Inside that, 6 to 8, 6 or 8, 6 or 8, not 7, okay, 6 or 8, rounded like structure are present, okay, that is called as synaptic vessels. Please. Carefully, you have to know that is 6 or 8. Clear? It is very to some part of neuron in our body, which are present in our body, some part, but minimum that is 6 or 8, and it will be maximum also. Okay, now see inside that. The power house is also present. Power house that you know in class 9, that is power house that is got mitochondria. This is mitochondria. Mitochondria is also present and synaptic vessels is also present. Okay. So this is the diagram. Okay. Now, so you know this one. This is diagram. Most important diagram, because I am going to tell you about that. Okay. In synaptic vessel, okay, some liquid is present. Liquid is present, that is a chemical called acetylcholine. Acetylcholine is a chemical, that is acetylcholine, which have basically the positive charge. Please learn it very carefully, because in 1 marks this question will come. Okay, clear? So acetylcholine. Next one. If the acetylcholine is present, what's its work? Its work as a neurotransmitter. Neurotransmitter. Why it was called as neurotransmitter? Neuro is equal to nerve or impulse. Transmitter is equal to transmit or transfer. Okay. It means this acetylcholine help to transfer the impulse to the different part of the body. Suppose that here one mosquito will bite or one ant will bite. So the information will be immediately move from this way to the brain, and from brain the information will become here. Okay. So which cell is responsible for the transmission of impulse? That is neuron, that is nerve cell. Nerve cell is in class 9, that you already know, that in nerve cell help to transmit the impulse from part to the brain and brain to the that part. Clear? So in 10th class, his question is asking which chemical is responsible for the transmission of impulse. So you write that what? Acetylcholine is the neurotransmitter. Clear this one? Now listen very carefully. So here that is completed. So the question is arise that is that only one neuron is present or one nerve cell is present in our body? So answer is no. There are so many nerve cells, so millions of nerve cells are present in our body. Some scientists were told that in a healthy person, if we combine all the nerve cell, then we will make a rope up to the sun or the moon. Okay, so just let that one. So question is arise that is there only one neuron or nerve cell is present in our body? So answer is no. Millions of nerves or neurons are present in our body. So the question, the main question is arise, which was come in the class 10th board examination, the how they are connected. If one neuron is here, second neuron is here, third neuron is here, fourth neuron is here, the how they are connected. Okay. So before the connecting, okay, I'm going to tell you one thing in class 9th that you also know, but here just I'm told you the remember one. You know the myelin sheath. So on the basis of myelin sheath, neuron are of two types. Number one, myelinated neuron means myelin sheath are present. In myelinated neuron, myelin sheath that you know, myelin sheath are present. And second one is non-myelinated neuron. Okay, so This is your homework. That is, which part of our body that non-myelinated neurons are present? First question. Okay, once again that I am going to repeat. Which part of our body that is non-myelinated neurons are present? Okay, question number one. Second question is that, in which neuron that is myelinated or non-myelinated, the impulse will be moved faster? In which neuron, it means myelinated or non-myelinated, the impulse will be moved faster? So this is the two question. So be remember. Okay. Now, so how they are connected? Question is that. Now first you see that. How neurons are connected. Okay, listen very carefully. Suppose that here is one neuron, okay, so here is another neuron. Okay, so suppose that here is the muscle, here that is muscle, okay, clear. So the dendrites will be originated. Suppose you see here it was connected. Suppose that it was the first neuron and it was the second neuron, and here if the branches is there as so on, that it was connected and reached to the brain. Clear? So here you see the first neurons, dendrites connect to the second neuron's synaptic knob. So how it was connected, you see that first neuron dendrites is connected to the second neuron's synaptic knob. Clear? Now here one question will become, just listen very carefully. This structure where one neuron dendrites and other neuron synaptic knob will be joined, called synapse. Okay, and this is in your syllabus, in class 10th syllabus. But if you are going in higher classes and you have to take bio, okay, so here you see this synaptic knob is also attached to the muscle. So this structure is called neuromuscular junction. So in higher classes, you have to know about the neuromuscular junction, because there are so many Z line, M line, so on. There are so many things are there. So in higher classes, that is neuromuscular junction will be there. But in your, that is 10th syllabus, that is only synapse will be there. Okay, so now let's further to the synapse. The question is arise that you have to know about the synapse. The basic, if you have seen synapse, what is synapse? The place where dendrites and synaptic nerve are joined, called as what? Synapse. The structure where dendrites of one neuron join to the synaptic knob of another neuron called synapse. Today, it means this lecture, I'm going to tell you the labeled and structural diagram of the synapse, and in the next lecture you have to know that how the impulse will be transferred. That one is most important, but first you know the structure of synapse, because so many things will be there and we remind the structure. Now come to the structure. Suppose that this is the synaptic knob and this is a dendrites. This is structure, you see. Okay, inside that synaptic vessels is there, mitochondria is there, okay. So the main thing just you remember, suppose here this is the muscle, suppose that here any mosquito will be bite, so the information will be moved from this way to the this way. It means first the information will become here, and after that it will be moved to the here. Okay, now this one. Okay, now this layer, it means this membrane here, is called as, first you see this one, synaptic vessels. You know the synaptic vessels, acetylcholine is present, which work as a neurotransmitter, that is positive charge. Now this layer is called presynaptic membrane. If you want to learn, that is pre means first. So this membrane receives the impulse firstly, okay, then the impulse will be transferred to this. So this membrane is called as post synaptic membrane. Presynaptic membrane and postsynaptic membrane. Clear this one. Now come to the next one. This one is mitochondria. Mitochondria is powerhouse, commonly called as powerhouse. Just left it. The gap which are present in between two, you see that gap, this one is a gap, is called as synaptic cleft. All the reactions will be take place in the synaptic cleft region. Okay, so from this you have to know the diagrams, all the diagram you have to just remind it, and please make it clearly and well labeled. Okay, clear. So thank you.